children, do you know who Abraham Lincoln was? Yes, you are absolutely right. Abraham Lincoln was the president of America. He was very much concerned with the grooming of his son. He wanted his son to have multidimensional personality. Therefore, he wrote a letter to his son's teacher in which he poured out his feelings regarding the grooming of his son. So today, we will read an extract from a letter. It is given in your English main course book under the heading Grooming of a Boy. But before reading the lesson, let us read about Abraham Lincoln. Vidyarthiyo, ki tusi jande ho ki Abraham Lincoln kaun si? Haan, tusi bilkul sahi ho. ਉਹ ਅਮਰੀਕਾ ਦੇ ਰਾਸ਼ਟਰਪਤੀ ਸੀ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਦੇਣ ਪ੍ਰਤੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਚਿੰਤਤ ਸੀ ਉਹ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਹਰ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦਾ ਗਿਆਨ ਹੋਵੇ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਉਸਨੇ ਇੱਕ ਪੱਤਰ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਦੇ ਅਧਿਆਪਕ ਨੂੰ ਲਿਖਿਆ ਜਿਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਦੀ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਸੰਬੰਧੀ ਆਪਣੀਆਂ ਭਾਵਨਾਵਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਵਿਅਕਤ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਲਈ ਅੱਜ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਸ ਪੱਤਰ ਦੇ ਸੰਖੇਪ ਰੂਪ ਨੂੰ ਪੜਾਂਗੇ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਇੰਗਲਿਸ਼ ਮੇਨ ਕੋਰਸ ਬੁੱਕ ਵਿੱਚ ਗਰੂਮਿੰਗ ਆਫ ਅ ਬੋਏ ਦੇ ਸਿਰਲੇਖ ਨਾਲ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਗਿਆ ਹੈ ਪਰ ਇਸ ਪਾਠ ਨੂੰ ਪੜਨ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਆਓ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਅਬਰਾਹਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਬਾਰੇ ਜਾਣ ਲਈਏ
ਅਬਰਾਹਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਬੋਰਨ 12th February 1809 US ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ 23rd March 1861 He became President of America on 23rd March 1861. Assassinated on 15th April 1865 by gunshot.
This letter is in the form of a poem, but it does not have any rhyme and rhythm. Now, I will explain it stanza-wise by giving the meanings of the difficult words. So, here we go.
He will have to learn, I know, that all men are not just, all men are not true.
Explanation. In the first stanza, Abraham Lincoln writes that his son has to learn that every man in this world is not honest and truthful. In other words, it is his teacher's duty to teach him that all the men in this world are not fair and truthful. Pehle stanza vich Abraham Lincoln likhda hai ki usde puttar nu sikhna pavega ki is duniya vich har koi imandar nahi hai. Dooje shabdan vich eh usde adhyapak da farz banda hai ਕਿ ਉਹ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਪੜਾਵੇ ਕਿ ਇਸ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਾਰੇ ਵਿਅਕਤੀ ਸੱਚੇ ਸੁੱਚੇ ਅਤੇ ਇਮਾਨਦਾਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਹਨ ਜਸਟ ਨਾਓ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਡਨ ਦ ਐਕਸਪਲੇਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦ ਫਰਸਟ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ਾ ਨਾਓ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਮੂਵ ਫਰਦਰ ਐਂਡ ਰੀਡ ਦ ਨੈਕਸਟ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ਾ
ਬਟ ਟੀਚ ਹਿਮ ਆਲਸੋ ਦੈਟ ਫਾਰ ਐਵਰੀ ਸਕਾਉਂਡਰਲ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਹੀਰੋ ਫਾਰ ਐਵਰੀ ਸੈਲਫਿਸ਼ ਪੋਲੀਟੀਸ਼ੀਅਨ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਡੈਡੀਕੇਟਿਡ ਲੀਡਰ
Let us have the meanings of a few difficult words. Words, meanings. Scoundrel, immoral, wicked, paaf, dusht. Selfish, caring only for oneself, paaf, swarthi, khudgarz. Dedicated, committed, paaf, samarpat. Explanation. In the first stanza, the writer says that his child should know that all the men in this world are not true. And in the second stanza, he says that though there are many wicked people, but even the good people are not less in number than the bad ones. If there are self-centered politicians, there are so many committed leaders. In other words, Abraham Lincoln wants his son to be taught to distinguish between good and bad and right and wrong. ਪਹਿਲੇ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਲੇਖਕ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਜਾਣਨਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਇਸ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਾਰੇ ਵਿਅਕਤੀ ਸੱਚੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਹਨ। ਪਰ ਦੂਜੇ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਾਰੇ ਬੁਰੇ ਲੋਕ ਹਨ, ਪਰ ਚੰਗੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ ਵੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਕਮੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ। ਜੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਖੁਦਗਰਜ਼ ਸਿਆਸਤਦਾਨ ਹਨ ਤਾਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਸਮਰਪਿਤ ਨੇਤਾਵਾਂ ਦੀ ਵੀ ਕਮੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ। ਚਿਲਡਰਨ, ਯੂ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਆਸਕਡ ਸਮ ਕੰਪ੍ਰੀਹੈਂਸਿਵ ਕੁਐਸਚਨਸ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮ। ਸੋ ਹੇਅਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਸੈਂਪਲ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ। ਦ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਇਜ਼, ਆਲ ਮੈਨ ਆਰ ਨਾਟ ਜਸਟ ਐਂਡ ਟਰੂ, ਬਟ ਵਾਈ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਔਥਰ ਸਟਿਲ ਹੋਪਫੁਲ? And the answer is, though everyone in this world is not just and true, but the author is still hopeful, because if there are a number of unjust, wicked and selfish people, there is no lack of just and good people also. Now read the next stanza.
Teach him, for every enemy there is a friend. It will take time, I know, but teach him if you can. That dollar earned is of far more value than five found.
Students, we will now have the explanation of this stanza along with the gist of it. Explanation. In these lines, Abraham Lincoln wants to tell his son that he should not worry about the number of his enemies, as the number of his friends is the same as that of the enemies. His son is very small, so it will take him long time to learn that hard-earned money, however small it may be, is more valuable than a big amount of money which is found or earned without any efforts. In a line which ਅਬਰਾਹਿਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਦੱਸਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਾਰੇ ਦੁਸ਼ਮਣਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਚਿੰਤਤ ਹੋਣ ਦੀ ਲੋੜ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਦੋਸਤਾਂ ਦੀ ਗਿਣਤੀ ਵੀ ਉਸਦੇ ਦੁਸ਼ਮਣਾਂ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਹੈ। ਉਸਦਾ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਬਹੁਤ ਛੋਟਾ ਹੈ, ਇਸ ਲਈ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਸਿਖਾਉਣ ਲਈ ਲੰਮਾ ਸਮਾਂ ਲੱਗੇਗਾ ਕਿ ਮਿਹਨਤ ਨਾਲ ਕਮਾਇਆ ਪੈਸਾ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਹੀ ਹੋਵੇ, ਇਸ ਦੀ ਕੀਮਤ ਉਸ ਪੈਸੇ ਨਾਲੋਂ ਕਿਤੇ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਬਿਨਾਂ ਕੋਈ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕੀਤੇ ਵੱਡੀ ਮਾਤਰਾ ਵਿੱਚ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਹੈ। ਜਿਸਟ, ਗੁੱਡ ਪੀਪਲ ਬਿਲੀਵ ਇਨ ਅਰਨਿੰਗ ਬਾਏ ਹਾਰਡ ਵਰਕ ਇਨਸਟੈਡ ਆਫ ਰਿਲਾਇੰਗ ਔਨ ਲੱਕ, ਔਰ ਹਾਰਡ ਵਰਕ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਪੇਜ਼ ਆਫ। ਸਿੱਟਾ, ਚੰਗੇ ਵਿਅਕਤੀ ਕਿਸਮਤ 'ਤੇ ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਬਜਾਏ ਮਿਹਨਤ ਕਰਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹਨ। Now read this stanza with me.
Teach him to learn to lose and also to enjoy winning. Steer him away from envy. If you can teach him the secret of quiet laughter.
Children, I think there are some difficult words in this stanza. So let me give the meanings of the difficult words. Words, meanings. Steer away, keep away, move away. ਭਾਵ ਦੂਰ ਰੱਖਣਾ। ਐਨਵੀ, ਜੈਲਸੀ, ਭਾਵ ਈਰਖਾ। ਐਕਸਪਲੇਨੇਸ਼ਨ। ਇਨ ਦੀਜ਼ ਲਾਈਨਸ ਅਬਰਾਹਿਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਵਾਂਟਸ ਹਿਸ ਸਨ ਟੂ ਲਰਨ ਟੂ ਰਿਮੇਨ ਕਾਮ ਇਨ ਫੇਲੀਅਰ ਐਂਡ ਟੂ ਇੰਜੋਏ ਦ ਵਿਕਟਰੀ ਡਿਊਰਿੰਗ ਸਕਸੈਸ। ਹੀ ਰਿਕੁਐਸਟਸ ਹਿਸ ਟੀਚਰ ਟੂ ਕੀਪ ਹਿਮ ਅਵੇ ਫਰੋਮ ਜੈਲਸੀ and to teach him the value of internal happiness. In a line which Abraham Lincoln chahunda hai ki usda puttar haar vich shant rahe ate safalta dauran jit da aanand maane. Oh usde adhyapak nu benti karda hai ki oh usnu irkha to dur rehen ate khamoshi naal hassan di sikhya deve. Children, you have read in this stanza that Abraham warns his son to be a flawless and a balanced personality whom everyone should adore. Now answer this question. And the question is, what should Lincoln's son be steered away from? And the answer is, Lincoln's son should be steered away from envy, or Lincoln's son should be steered away from jealousy.
Let him learn early that bullies are the easiest to lick.
Children, I would like to tell the meaning of the word bullies before explaining the stanza. Word meaning, bullies, quarrelsome, overbearing person, bhav, takkar, chagdalu. Explanation. In these lines, Abraham Lincoln wants his son to learn this at very early stage of the life, that the quarrelsome and overbearing people can be defeated very easily. In a line which Abraham Lincoln chahunda hai ki usda puttar jeevan de mudle padav vich hi eh samajh jave ki chagdalu ate bardasht na kar sakan wale lokan nu badi aasani nal haraya ja sakda hai. Children, you have read that Abraham Lincoln requests his son's teacher to make him a good human being by teaching him to learn good habits and by moving away from evil things. In these two lines, he warns his son not to fear from the quarrelsome people because they are very easy to defeat or can be easily defeated. Now read this stanza.
Teach him, if you can, the wonder of books, but also give him quiet time to ponder the eternal mystery of birds in the sky, bees in the sun, and flowers on a green hillside.
Now look at the meanings of some difficult words from this stanza. Words, meanings. Ponder, to think about. Bhav, vicharna. Eternal, everlasting. Bhav, amar. Mystery, secret, wonder, or something difficult to understand. Bhav, pet, rehas, ja, raz. Explanation. In these lines, the writer wants his son to be given bookish knowledge, but at the same time, he wishes that the teacher should teach his son to enjoy beauty of the nature. He should enjoy looking at the bees, collecting honey at the daytime. He should spare time to enjoy the scenery of beautiful flowers on the green hills. In a line which, kavi chahunda hai ki usde puttar nu kitabi gyan ditta jave. ਪਰ ਉਸੇ ਸਮੇਂ ਉਹ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਅਧਿਆਪਕ ਨੂੰ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਕੁਦਰਤ ਦੀ ਸੁੰਦਰਤਾ ਦਾ ਆਨੰਦ ਮਾਣਨ ਦੀ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਵੀ ਦੇਣੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੀ ਹੈ। ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਦਿਨ ਦੇ ਸਮੇਂ ਸ਼ਹਿਦ ਦੀਆਂ ਮੱਖੀਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਸ਼ਹਿਦ ਇਕੱਠਾ ਕਰਦਿਆਂ ਵੇਖ ਦਾ ਆਨੰਦ ਮਾਣਨਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ। ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਹਰੇ ਪਹਾੜਾਂ ਉੱਪਰ ਸੁੰਦਰ ਫੁੱਲਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਜ਼ਾਰੇ ਵੇਖਣ ਲਈ ਸਮਾਂ ਕੱਢਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ। ਚਿਲਡਰਨ, ਦ ਰਾਈਟਰ ਹੇਅਰ ਮੀਨਸ that a good student is the one who is not only enriched with the bookish knowledge but is also aware of his surroundings as well. Now answer the question. What should one ponder about? And the answer is, one should ponder about the eternal mystery of the birds in the sky, bees in the sun, and flowers on a green hillside. Or, one should ponder about the wonders of the nature. Now we will move ahead with the next stanza.
Teach him to be gentle in the school. Teach him. It is far more honorable to fail than to cheat.
Children, you have read the stanza. Now let us explain it. Explanation. In these lines, the writer requests the teacher to make his son a good student who believes in hard work and avoids cheating. In a line which, kavi adhyapak agge binti karda hai ke o usde puttar nu vadiya vidyarthi banave jehda sakht mehnat kare ate nakal ton kinara kare. The writer in these lines asked the teacher to teach his son to be an honest and hardworking. He wants his son to follow the motto. It is better to fail than to cheat. Now let us read the next stanza.
Teach him to have faith in his own ideas, even if everyone tells him they are wrong.
Children, now you have understood that Abraham Lincoln wants his son to become a good human being. The explanation of the stanza is as follows. Explanation. In this stanza, the writer wants his son to have trust on himself. He should be so confident about himself that no one can deceive him. ਇਹਨਾਂ ਲਾਈਨਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਵੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ 'ਤੇ ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ, ਉਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਪਣੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਇੰਨਾ ਭਰੋਸਾ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਕੋਈ ਵੀ ਉਸ ਨਾਲ ਦਗਾ ਨਾ ਕਰ ਸਕੇ. Now we shall see what more does Abraham Lincoln wants the teacher to teach his son.
Teach him to be gentle with the gentle and tough with the tough.
Now see the explanation of the above stanza. Explanation. In these lines, Abraham Lincoln wants his son's teacher to teach his son to behave nicely with the good ones and harshly with the bad ones. ਇਹਨਾਂ ਲਾਈਨਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਵੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਦਾ ਅਧਿਆਪਕ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਚੰਗੇ ਵਿਅਕਤੀਆਂ ਨਾਲ ਹਲੀਮੀ ਨਾਲ ਅਤੇ ਬੁਰੇ ਵਿਅਕਤੀਆਂ ਨਾਲ ਕੁਰੱਖਤ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਪੇਸ਼ ਆਉਣ ਬਾਰੇ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਦੇਵੇ. Now read this stanza and find what more Abraham Lincoln expects from the teacher.
Try to give my son the strength not to follow the crowd when everyone is getting on the bandwagon.
Children, I hope you have understood the theme of this stanza. If not, let me explain. Explanation. In these lines, the writer requests the teacher to teach his son one more very good quality of a good human being. He wants his son not to follow the crowd like a sheep. He should have the understanding of wrong and right. In a line which kavi adhyapak nu binti karta hai ki oh ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਹੋਰ ਵਧੀਆ ਮਨੁੱਖ ਬਣਨ ਦਾ ਗੁਣ ਦੇਵੇ ਕਿ ਉਸਦਾ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਭੇਡਾਂ ਵਾਂਗ ਪੀੜ ਦੇ ਪਿੱਛੇ ਪਿੱਛੇ ਨਾ ਚੱਲੇ. ਉਸਨੂੰ ਸਹੀ ਅਤੇ ਗਲਤ ਦੀ ਪਛਾਣ ਹੋਣੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੀ ਹੈ. ਚਿਲਡਰਨ, ਯੂ ਸੀ ਦੈਟ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਕੇਅਰਿੰਗ ਫਾਦਰ ਐਂਡ ਵਾਂਟਸ ਹਿਸ ਸਨ ਟੂ ਹੈਵ ਦ ਬੈਸਟ ਆਫ ਐਵਰੀਥਿੰਗ. ਨਾਓ ਰੀਡ ਦਿਸ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ਾ.
ਟੀਚ ਹਿਮ ਟੂ ਲਿਸਨ ਟੂ ਆਲ ਮੈਨ, ਬਟ ਟੀਚ ਹਿਮ also to filter all that he hears on a screen of truth and take only the good that comes through.
Lincoln is talking about one more good quality of a human being. Explanation. In these lines, the writer wishes his son to have the patience of listening to everyone. He should learn the art of identification of good from bad and should choose only the good things. In a line which kavi chahunda hai ki usde puttar de vich har ik di gal sunan da maada hona chahida hai, us vich bure chon changa labban da hunar hona chahida hai ate oh sirf changiyan gallan hi sikhe. Children, there is another good quality of a human being which is mentioned here. A good human being always listens to everybody carefully and then retains the good things, rejects the bad ones. Vidyarthiyo, itthe manukh de ik hor change gun da zikr kita gaya hai. Ik changa manukh har ik di gal bade dhyan naal sunda hai ate buriyan gallan nu nazar andaz karta hai. Now answer the question. After listening to all the men, what should one do? And the answer is, after listening to all the men, one should only pick what is good. Now read this stanza.
Teach him, if you can, how to laugh when he is sad. Teach him there is no shame in tears. Teach him to scoff at cynics and to be aware of too much sweetness.
We will have the meanings of the difficult words. Words, meanings. Scoff, to make fun of. Paav, mazaak udauna. Cynics, a person who do not believe in others' goodness. Paav, kise di achhai te vishwas na karan wala. Beware of, be careful. Paav, savdhan raho. Now let me explain this tense. Explanation. In these lines, the writer says that his son should learn the art of being happy even in displeasure. He should also know that it is not humiliating if he weeps at any instance. His teacher should teach him to make fun of those who do not believe in others' goodness. Abraham Lincoln wants his son to be careful from the people who talk sweet. ਇਹਨਾਂ ਲਾਈਨਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਵੀ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਖੁਸ਼ ਰਹਿਣ ਦਾ ਗੁਣ ਸਿੱਖਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ, ਇੱਥੋਂ ਤੱਕ ਦੁੱਖ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ। ਉਸਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਜਾਣਨਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਜੇ ਉਹ ਕਿਸੇ ਸੂਰਤ ਵਿੱਚ ਰੋਂਦਾ ਵੀ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਇਹ ਅਪਮਾਨਜਨਕ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ। ਉਸਦੇ ਅਧਿਆਪਕ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਦੱਸਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦਾ ਮਖੌਲ ਉਡਾਏ ਜੋ ਦੂਜਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਚੰਗੇ ਕੰਮਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ ਨਹੀਂ ਰੱਖਦੇ। ਅਬਰਾਹਿਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦਾ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਸਾਵਧਾਨ ਰਹੇ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਮਿੱਠਾ ਬੋਲਦੇ ਹਨ। ਨਾਓ ਲੈਟ ਮੀ ਟੈਸਟ ਯੂ, ਆਨਸਰ ਦਿਸ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ। What should one be aware of? One should beware of the people who talk too sweetly. Yes, your answer is absolutely right. Now read the next stanza carefully.
Teach him to sell his brawn and brain to the highest bidders, but never to put a price tag on his heart and soul.
Now we shall look for the meanings of the difficult words. Words, meanings. Brawn, strong, well-developed muscles. Paav, takatwar. Bidders, a person who offers to pay an amount. Paav, kharidar. Price tag, labeled value. Paav, kimat lagauna. Explanation. In these lines, the writer requests the teacher to teach his son to sell his hard work but not to sell his heart and soul. In a line which kavi adhyapak nu binti karda hai ki o usde puttar nu apni sakht mehnat nu vechan bare sikhya deve par apne dil ate atma nu vechan bare nahi. Here is a question for you from this stanza. What should one never sell? And the answer is, one should never sell one's soul. Now read the next stanza.
Teach him to close his ears to a howling mob and to stand and fight if he thinks he is right.
As there is just one difficult word, so we shall have the meaning of it and then move ahead with the explanation. Word, meaning. Mob, crowd of people. Paav, peer. Here is the explanation of the same stanza. Explanation. In these lines, the writer wants his son to learn to avoid unimportant people, and at the same time, he should have courage to face them if he thinks it is necessary. ਇਹਨਾਂ ਲਾਈਨਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਵੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸ ਦਾ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਮਹੱਤਵਹੀਣ ਵਿਅਕਤੀਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਨਜ਼ਰਅੰਦਾਜ਼ ਕਰਨਾ ਸਿੱਖੇ ਅਤੇ ਉਸੇ ਸਮੇਂ ਜੇ ਉਹ ਸੋਚਦਾ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਉਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਸਾਹਮਣਾ ਕਰਨ ਦਾ ਹੌਸਲਾ ਵੀ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ। Now read the next stanza.
Treat him gently, but do not cuddle him, because only the test of fire makes fine steel.
Here are some difficult words to be comprehended. Words, meanings. Cuddle, pamper, hold closely, pav, vadere laad pyar karna. Gently, kindly, pav, narmi naal. Now read the explanation for the stanza. Explanation. In these lines, the writer requests the teacher to treat his son nicely but should not pamper him so that he can learn to struggle and come up as a fine personality. Inna line vich kavi adhyapak nu benti karta hai ki usde puttar nu ਵਧੀਆ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਦੇਵੇ ਪਰ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਵਧੇਰੇ ਲਾਡ ਪਿਆਰ ਨਾਲ ਵਿਗਾੜ ਨਾ ਦੇਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਉਸਦਾ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਸੰਘਰਸ਼ ਕਰਨਾ ਸਿੱਖੇ ਅਤੇ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਇੱਕ ਚੰਗਾ ਇਨਸਾਨ ਬਣ ਕੇ ਸਾਹਮਣੇ ਆਏ। ਚਿਲਡਰਨ, ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਸੀਨ ਦੈਟ ਹੇਅਰ ਅਬਰਾਹਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਵਾਂਟਸ ਹਿਸ ਸਨ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਅ ਸੈਲਫ ਮੇਡ ਨੋਬਲ ਪਰਸਨੈਲਿਟੀ। ਨਾਓ ਆਨਸਰ ਦਿਸ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ, ਵਾਈ ਡਜ਼ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਵਾਂਟ ਹਿਸ ਸਨ not to be cuddled? And the answer is, Lincoln wants his son not to be cuddled because he wants his son to struggle and come out as a fine personality. Now read this stanza carefully.
Let him have the courage to be impatient. Let him have the patience to be brave. Teach him always to have sublime faith in himself, because then he will always have sublime faith in mankind.
Children, you have read the stanza. I hope you have understood that here Lincoln wants to teach his son to have courage, patience, and self-confidence. Now read it in detail. Explanation. In these lines, Abraham Lincoln warns that his son should have the boldness to be restless about the wrong and should have the firmness to be brave to do good. He requests the teacher to teach his son to trust himself. Abraham says that the person who trusts himself can have trust in mankind. ਇਹਨਾਂ ਲਾਈਨਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਬਰਾਹਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੁੱਤਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਗਲਤ ਲਈ ਬੇਚੈਨ ਹੋਣ ਦਾ ਹੌਸਲਾ ਹੋਵੇ ਅਤੇ ਬਹਾਦਰ ਬਣਨ ਲਈ ਦ੍ਰਿੜਤਾ ਹੋਵੇ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਅਬਰਾਹਮ ਲਿੰਕਨ ਅਨੁਸਾਰ ਕੇਵਲ ਉਹੀ ਇਨਸਾਨ ਮਨੁੱਖਤਾ ਵਿੱਚ ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ ਰੱਖ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ ਜਿਸ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ 'ਤੇ ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ ਹੋਵੇ। ਨਾਓ ਆਨਸਰ ਦਿਸ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ, ਹਾਊ ਕੈਨ ਵਨ ਗੇਨ ਸਬਲਾਈਮ ਫੇਥ ਇਨ ਮੈਨਕਾਈਂਡ? And the answer is, one can have sublime faith in mankind by having sublime faith in oneself. Children, now read the last stanza.
This is a big order, but see what you can do. He is such a fine little fellow, my son.
Now look for the explanation. Explanation. In the last, Abraham Lincoln tells the teacher that he has expected a lot from him by giving him a big list of good qualities. But it is up to him to try his best to draw out maximum from the young boy. Antam line vich Abraham Lincoln apne puttar de adhyapak nu kehnda hai ki usne adhyapak nu change gunan di vaddi list deke ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਦੀ ਉਮੀਦ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ, ਪਰ ਹੁਣ ਇਹ ਉਸ 'ਤੇ ਨਿਰਭਰ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਇੱਕ ਛੋਟੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੂੰ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਵੱਧ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਧ ਸਿਖਾ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ। ਨਾਓ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਰੈਡ ਆਲ ਦ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ਾਸ। ਈਚ ਸਟੈਂਜ਼ਾ ਟੈਲਸ ਅਸ ਵਨ or the more good qualities of a human being? Now answer the questions. The first question is, what are the qualities which make a good human being? And the answer is, a good human being should be just and true, a man of principles and dedicated, nature loving, confident, a leader, intelligent, realistic. The next question is, what is the theme of the lesson? And the answer is, the parents expect that the teacher can play an important role in shaping the personality of their ward. His responsibility is not thus confined to academics only. He is responsible for the development of child's all-round personality as well. With this, we come to the end of our episode. Hope you liked it and would try to build up good qualities in you with the help of your teacher. Till then, goodbye.